In today's video, we're going to be talking about how to deepen and enhance current relationships as a way to help prevent or recover from depression. Hi, everyone. We know that social support is extremely important for preventing and recovering from depression. And so what we're going to be talking about in today's video is ways of enhancing your social support by deepening your current relationships. But before I get into that, just a couple of disclaimers to go over. I'm a registered psychologist in the province of British Columbia, Canada, and this video is for informational purposes only. It is not intended as a substitute or replacement for advice from your doctor or mental health professional. Now, with those things out of the way, let's start talking about deepening current relationships. Now, in a previous video, I talked about ways of understanding your social support network as kind of like a bullseye, with you in the center and various rings of people around you, depending on the level of closeness or connection in those relationships. And we talked about the different forms of relationships in your social network, and how for a lot of people, their social network isn't ideal. That the number of people that we have in our social network tends to be lacking. And this can particularly be the case for people if they're experiencing depression. And so there's three main ways to enhance your social network and your levels of social connections. The first is deepening current relationships, reconnecting with former relationships, or starting new relationships. And so in today's video, we're going to be focusing on the first one, which is deepening current relationships. And that's typically where I start with my clients, because I find that it's easiest to look at enhancing your social life by focusing on the relationships that you actually have in your life right now. And the way we do this is by thinking about the people in the social network and trying to take people from those outer rings and move them into the inner rings. And that's what deepening these current relationships are. So it's things like taking maybe familiar faces and making them acquaintances. It could be taking people who are other friends, people you'd consider friends, but deepening the relationship to make them close friends. Now, the thing is, we do this all the time naturally. It's how we form close relationships. We start with meeting someone, we've never known them before, they become a familiar face, and if they become a close friend, they work their way through these various rings. So this isn't something that's novel or foreign, it's something we always do. But if you're experiencing depression, it can be, it may not seem so natural in terms of deepening these relationships, and you may have lost connections with people or have difficulty making connections with people, and that's part of the problem and that's part of the difficulty with the social network. So here are some practical tips for some things that you can do to deepen your current relationships. So the first thing, this may seem pretty obvious, but I think it's important to point out, is that you need to make relationships a priority. You have to make an effort and prioritize deepening relationships over other things like chores, like doing yard work or, you know, mopping the floor, or other solitary activities that you might enjoy doing, like reading or watching TV or playing video games. If you're not making social connections or enhancing your social connections a priority over those other activities, it makes it really difficult to deepen relationships. Another thing you want to do is you want to focus on regularity. And what I mean by this is you want to try and have regular meetings with people. So maybe it's arranging to have a monthly coffee with a friend. So let's try to get together the last Friday of every month to have coffee together. Maybe it's arranging to have a weekly walk with a friend or an acquaintance. The idea is you don't want to let too much time pass between your interactions, because either the connection, the relationship doesn't really form because you're not really spending that much time together or not seeing each other very regularly. Or if it's a closer relationship, it's been so long since you last saw them, you spend all of your time catching up about what's happened in the last 6 months, as opposed to actually deepening some of the aspects of the relationship. Now, when you're interacting with people, one of the ways to sort of deepen your sense of connection in the relationship is to open up about yourself. And this can be really hard because we don't really like to pull back the curtain or let people know what's really going on for us. But it's important to look for opportunities to share your feelings, share your opinions, share your experiences that you may not typically share with people. Speak in a personal way, sharing things about yourself that you know, maybe you're not sure if the other person wants to hear. So I like to think of it almost like you got this door and you open up the door a little bit and you share something personal about yourself and you let the door close a bit and see how the other person responds. If they open up a little bit about themselves and the door closes, well, then you know that they're interested and they want to share more. And so you open up your door a little bit, share a little bit more. So it's about reading how the other person is responding to you and sharing information appropriately. This way you prevent that problem of too much personal disclosure, where you're sharing way more information about yourself than the other person's comfortable with. But it also prevents the pitfall of not sharing anything about you, not sharing anything personal. And so the person doesn't really get to know anything about you as a person, what you feel, what you believe, what you think. Now, related to this, it's important to be vulnerable. And what I mean by that is it's important to share what's not going right in your world and in your life. Allow them to see behind the social media highlight reel that you typically share with people. You know, like when we're posting on Facebook or Instagram, we just share all of like the really cool things that are happening in our lives. But some of the things that are not working out so well, we kind of hide those. Being vulnerable means sharing some of the stuff that's not going well and seeing how the other person responds, essentially giving that other person an opportunity to provide support for you. Because if you're opening up and you're being vulnerable with them and giving them the opportunity to provide support for you, there's a good chance that they'll open up and let you in to some of the difficulties that they're having. And that's a really powerful way of deepening a sense of connection with the other person. Now, the thing is, we're all busy. We all have lots of things going on in our lives, so it can seem really challenging of how do I incorporate these social connection efforts when I've got all of these other things to do in my life? Well, one of the things you can do is to combine activities. So layer socializing on top of other things you have to do anyway. So invite a person to go shopping with you, go exercise or go for walks together, carpool together to work, set up play dates with your kids. These are all things that you may have to do otherwise, but you're adding socializing to it as well. And so that can increase kind of the regularity or the opportunity of interaction with the other person. You also want to cast a large net. What you want to try and do is to maintain friendships or to deepen friendships with a number of people rather than just focusing on one person. Again, the idea here is that you want to build a social network, not just invest everything in a single person. And so try to look for opportunities to enhance relationships with different people in different parts of your network. So we tend to focus very much on kind of those inner rings, like the close friends and those intimate relationships. But those can be the most challenging and most difficult to form because they are the closest. But there's no harm in also looking at deepening relationships in some of those outer rings. So taking people who may just be familiar faces and looking for ways to deepen the relationship so that maybe they become an acquaintance. So look for opportunities throughout your social network to enhance those relationships. So you're probably thinking to yourself, okay, Rami, this makes a lot of sense, that's great, but how do I actually use these ideas, use these tips to actually enhance my social network? How do I actually put this information into practice? And so what I typically do with my clients is I get them to think about one person that they'd like to deepen their relationship with. And to think about who that person is. How often do you see them? And when you see them, what do you usually do with them? What do you usually talk about? You want to assess that relationship and think about why exactly do you want to deepen this relationship? What's the value or the purpose in deepening this relationship? And once you've identified that person and recognized that there is value in deepening the relationship, the idea is to generate ideas. In what ways can I set up opportunities to see this person more often? Are there specific things that we might be able to do together that maybe we haven't been doing? Are there ways when I'm interacting with this person that I can relate to them differently? Are there ways or opportunities for me to open up more with this other person? Are there different topics that we can discuss to sort of deepen the relationship? So maybe we always tend to talk about sports. Well, maybe rather than just talking about sports, we can also start to talk about our families or our kids or some of the challenges with, you know, being a dad, for example. And so you come up with really sort of practical ideas and plans for thinking about how do I enhance or deepen the relationship with this person. And to work out those plans, like I said, for multiple people. Now, one of the things that people will sometimes say to me when I'm encouraging them to come up with these plans to deepen relationships is they say, this feels really inauthentic. It feels very kind of forced or non-organic. And I get it. Because it is kind of inauthentic. We typically in our day-to-day lives aren't coming up with plans for how to deepen our relationships. But if depression is contributing to your social network getting smaller, if depression is contributing to you feeling sort of more isolated or withdrawn from other people, then you need to be more conscious about enhancing these social networks. Because if you're just allowing yourself to go by how you feel, well, you're probably not going to feel like reaching out to people. You're not going to feel like sharing more about what's going on with you. And that's one of those problems with depression I've talked about in previous videos. If you follow what you feel like doing in depression, it tends to make the depression worse. So yes, it's a little bit inauthentic. Yes, it may not feel natural or a natural way of deepening relationships, but it's the most effective way of deepening relationships to have a plan, particularly if you're experiencing a reduction in your social network because of depression. So I hope all of that makes sense. I'd love to hear your thoughts and ideas about this, so please leave me some comments in the comments section down below. If you're enjoying my videos and would like to see more, please hit that subscribe button and notification bell, and you'll be alerted every week when I post a new video. So that's all for today's video. As always, thank you for making it all the way to the end of this video, and I will see you in the next one.